you explain us what is the job of a clinician study technician? Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to thank you for inviting us here today. I am Valérie Lebeau, a clinical study technician at Corevi Paris. This afternoon, my colleague Marie-Pierre and I are going to be telling you about our work. We are delighted to present our job at this conference on sexual health. We work at the Hôtel Dieu Hospital in Paris. This is the first time we have participated in the conference on sexual health, and it is our first presentation in English. Please, show me. Here is an overview of our presentation. First of all, we will look at the profession of clinical study technician, then the missions, and finally, our involvement with sexual health. Clinical study technician missions can vary from one country to another. Our presentation shows the task and action within our Corevi Île-de-France Sud. The profession of clinical study technician was created at the end of the 80s by the Ministry of Health at the beginning of the HIV pandemic. Training was made accessible to hospital paramedical or administrative staff. And then the clinical study technician joined the hospital departments in charge of HIV patients and of monitoring the epidemic. We now work in the healthcare structure within the Corevi. We work with doctors, pharmacists, paramedical or administrative staff in charge of HIV patients. Our task is to collect epidemiological data to implement clinical research protocols and to participate in the various sections set up by our Corevi. We are regularly trained in various subjects as required by our jobs evolutions, data processing, protocols, new molecules, and recently sexual health. We are in charge of collecting data on HIV patients. Data collected during medical consultation or hospitalization are biology, pathologies, treatment, etc. All this data is coded and sent to the FHDA through a specific program called DOMEVI. The FHDH is the French Hospital HIV Database, set up in 1989. To date, there are about 184,000 patients from 105 hospitals in the database. The main objectives are to study therapeutic strategies, morbidity and mortality, and the impact of infection or treatments. We must regularly provide the authorities and other health sectors with data required to monitor the epidemic, activity reports, compulsory reporting of HIV or AIDS. Here is an example of data for the activity reports. On the top graph, you can see the number of patients in the various hospitals linked with the Corevi, a total of 12,239 patients from 9 hospitals. On the second graph, we can see that the evolution of immunovirological markers is stable over 3 years. We are close to the WHO objective of 95% of patients treated and with an undetected viral load.
An important part of our work is dedicated to research. We participate in clinical and therapeutic trials and in cohorts from private pharmaceutical companies and from public organizations such as the National AIDS Research Agency. When a protocol is accepted in our hospital, we participate in the various implementation meetings. We go through our database so as to find potential patients for the study. We are then in charge of the timetable for patients' appointments, of data entry for an internet program that we call ECLF. Data is regularly reviewed by clinical research assistants from the study sponsor, Once the study is completed, we take good care in storing the documents, which must be kept for at least 15 years. Throughout the trials, we ensure that good clinical practice is respected. We also process data from our database for publication and posters. We have contributed to posters such as hospitalization of over 24 hours for HIV patients and tolerance to WDI. We also participate in international partnerships. We went to Togo to set up trials, in particular to determine the prevalence of HIV, HPV infection, as well as risk reduction of mother-to-child transmission thanks to antiretroviral treatment. We train local teams in good clinical practice and study follow-up. We can also participate in inter-collegial groups on regional and local issues. For instance, we are part of a group on the yearly activity report and another on the cartography of persons who are the hidden reservoir of the infection. We attend various events organized by our colleagues, such as conferences or evening sessions. Following the new decree of 2017, the COREVIS must now address over STIs and sexual health. The COREVIS staff was trained in 2018 on such topics. Knowledge is put into practice during prevention sessions and also enable us to talk with various population groups. Recently, we started collecting data on STIs and sexual health within different organizations such as sexual health centers. In complementary, with the other actors, health insurance and resist network. Since 2015, jointly with ANETS and anti-LGBT discrimination outfit, we have been carrying out surveys on HIV, STIs and sexual health among young people during a music festival called Solidays. Our COREVIS coordinates these events. We are part of the organized committee, and we are also interviewers. Once data is processed, we analyze and publish results. If you wish, we can see the two surveys here on our posters. This year, along with the Otaji Hospital Sexual Health Center, we have written and carried out a protocol called EVA on knowledge and coverage of recommended vaccination in MSM. The survey, which involved 219 men, is currently being processed. Our COREVIS also plays a part in prevention and testing. We attend prevention sessions in universities, in hospitals, for instance, on World AIDS Day on December 1st. We also attend events organized by other bodies, such as Solidays Festival. We can provide in a population group with information, and we use educational tools provided by the COREVIS. One of our projects is to cooperate with our hospital sexual health center for testing outside. To conclude, the job of clinical study technician has many facets that make it specific and interesting. We are bonus for research to be carried out in the best possible way. In some cases, we can be go-betweens for doctor and patients. Our job is in constant evolution depending on department needs, official directives, but also our inclinations. Thank you for listening. We would particularly like to thank Philippe Sabou, without whom all this would never have happened, and Professor Dominique Salmon, thanks to her energy